Welcome to SciJoy. Today we are going to be talking about how to build a high-tech bat house. GetMessy asked us to do a collaboration with her. Over on her channel, she's going to talk about the science behind bats, and we're going to use that knowledge to build a bat house. We're going to make these bats a nice summer home. During the winter, they spend their time in caves. It's nice and cold in there, so it slows down their metabolism for when they're hibernating. But during the summer, all the females like to get together in a maternity roost, and that's where they're going to raise their young. Bat boxes should be made from non-pressure treated wood. They come in a variety of sizes and designs, so we've put a bunch of the plans down in the description below. We just used some scrap wood we had from other projects that we've done, so ours is a little bit different in size, but yours should be at least 20 inches tall and 14 inches wide. Your bat box is going to have a landing pad for the bats. It's going to extend at least 4 inches below the bottom, and this way the bats can land on here and climb up inside. Inside your house is going to be several baffles, and whether it's your attic or the bat box you build them, or the inside of a tree, bats like to live in pre-made living quarters. In the wild, they take over places that squirrels or birds have already made. Mothers feel safest when they put their young in tight spaces, so you're going to want your baffles to be spaced 3/4 to 1 inch apart. If you have small bats, you can go down to 1/2 inch, and if you're dealing with larger bats, you can go up to 1.5 inches. Bat Conservation International has done a lot of research to figure out what kind of houses that bats like best, and they say any house that has 3 or more baffles is more likely to be inhabited. And you're going to want the backboard in each of the baffles to be scored on one side. You can also use heavy plastic that you staple down every few inches. But don't use fiberglass or nylon because they easily fall apart and they'll probably trap your bats. You should put a roof on your bat house, and if you can, try and make it angled so the water runs off or use roofing materials. You want a nice weather-safe house for your bats. So during your final assembly, you're going to want to caulk all the edges and seal it up. You're going to want to have an open bottom on your bat house, because you don't want other creatures to crawl inside and make a nest, and you also don't want to clean up the droppings of 100 bats. To create the bat box, we actually cut out the backboard, the front board, a roof, 2 sides, and all the baffles inside, and individual spacers. Make sure you wear gloves and safety glasses. We pre-drilled all of the holes and used exterior grade wood screws to attach all the pieces. We tried to score the baffle and the backboard using a row of screws, but that didn't work out very well. So instead we used a circular saw to make cuts in the wood. When you're all done, you should stain or paint the wood a dark water-based color. We didn't put caulk on it yet because we need to install our electronics, but during your final assembly, you should seal up the entire house. There are 2 things mother bats are looking for in a house: safety and warmth. To provide safety, you can put the bat box 15 to 20 feet in the air, you can have tight living quarters, and an open bottom. They want a house that's between 80 and 100 degrees Fahrenheit. If you paint the outside a dark color, you have a nice roof on it, you seal up the outside and you put it in a sunny area, you're probably going to be able to maintain the temperatures that the bats want. But sometimes these bats are going to get too hot, so you want a nice tall structure so they can go from a hotter area down to a cooler area. And if you put slits in the bottom of your box, a couple inches from the bottom, they're also going to be able to have air circulating through, but make sure these slits aren't too wide because you don't want other predators to get inside. Sometimes if you build multiple bat houses, you can put some in sunny areas and some in shady areas. This allows for the bats to pick what temperature house they want to be in during different parts of the day. It also allows them to avoid predators. But no matter where you're building these bat boxes, you're going to want to put them near some kind of fresh water resource. Since temperature is so important for creating a good bat house, we wanted to monitor how warm our house got. We will be installing weather-resistant temperature sensors at various locations in the house. These will be out of the way of the bats. We will monitor the outside temperature of the bat house using a weather station. The temperature data will be sent over Wi-Fi using a photon. This way we don't disturb the bats while we're trying to collect our data. The electronics will all be housed inside a box and powered by a solar panel and a battery. After some field testing, we're going to be releasing the code and the wiring diagrams for you guys to use. And if you build a bat box or set up these electronics, please let us know. You should watch the other half of this collaboration over on GetMessy's channel to learn more great facts about bats. Thank you for watching this episode of SciJoy. You can talk to us down in the comments below on Facebook, Twitter, Tumblr, Instagram, or Reddit. And remember, keep exploring.